So we know it certainly feels like fall out there, and we're talking grounds, we're talking all the football games and tailgating, and we're marrying that with the fall apples. And Larry Burnett from Longhorn Steakhouse is here with right now. This is amazing and smells amazing. So talk about, you're actually putting apple cider into
our barbecue sauce.
Oh my goodness, that's like the perfect marriage.
Yes,
I'm sorry.
Is. Yes, it is. I mean, going with the tailgating, go Browns, we're ready for this.
Woo! Right.
We're figuring out, you know, you like bratwurst, you like your hamburgers, you like your hot dogs. Everyone loves ribs too.
Yes.
Don't you?
Yes.
I certainly do. So we're going to start with showing you how you can do this at home and take it right to your tailgate.
Perfect. All right. Sounds good. Let's start. Let's not waste any time.
We're not going to.
Please.
We're not going to. We're going to take a regular rack of ribs. You can buy them at the butcher shop.
Okay.
Or at your local grocery store. After that, you take them home, put them in your pan. They'll start off like this. You're going to want to cut them in half.
Okay.
We'll just right here.
Those look beautiful.
Oh, these are baby back ribs.
Nice. Look gorgeous.
We have a bone here. There
okay.
we go. We're going to flip them over, meat side down.
Okay.
And you're going to pour your cider right on the top.
Just apples. And we have some of the best here in Northeast Ohio.
Yes,
we really have some
Would
great
you like
fruit
to pour
farms.
It right over?
Yes. Okay. So just like this. This is just your
just
apple
like
cider,
that.
Right? Nice.
You're going to pour it, and it's going to cook exactly like that.
Oh, yum. All right.
Yes, it is.
Okay.
You can also season them as well. Now, we have a special seasoning at Longhorn. I can't tell you what it is. But what you can do, you can do
Come
the big
on.
Four. No,
okay.
I can't. You can do the big four at home because everyone has them in their pantry.
Okay.
You can use salt, black pepper, garlic powder, and onion powder.
Okay.
You have them at home. So you can take that.
All right.
Sprinkle it right on pretty generously. The more seasoning,
more
the more
so?
Tender.
Okay.
Go ahead and put them right here.
Really? And then how long do you let it marinate in this or no?
You don't have to let it marinate. You could if you wanted to. You can make this actually a day and a half. You can season them, marinate like such. Take your foil. You're going to put it right over.
Okay.
Just
you could do
like
that a
that.
Day and a half early?
Yeah, because what you want to do is you want to cook them the night before your tailgate because you want them to cool. Because
okay.
if you take them right out the oven and you take them right to the parking lot and you throw them on the grill, they're going to fall apart on you because they're going to be that tender.
Okay. What do we do with the mac and cheese?
The mac and cheese, that's an excellent side that we have at Longhorn right now. We have a steakhouse mac and cheese, which is our four cheese sauce, corkscrew pasta, and bacon.
That looks amazing.
We also have potatoes au gratin with leeks.
Oh, wow, that looks great.
Oh, it's delicious.
Oh, it looks good. Okay, that's a perfect side for this. All right, so now we marinate for a day and a half or
you
a
marinate,
day or the night before,
well,
or whatever you want.
You marinate for 4 hours.
Okay.
You're going to throw them in the oven at 325 for about 2.5 hours.
Okay.
Okay, after that, you take them out. Uncover them, put them in your refrigerator overnight. That's where the day and a half process will come
gotcha.
In.
Gotcha, all right.
Afterwards,
this
they should look
amazing.
Exactly like this when you take them.
Okay.
Because they're still kind of stiff here. You're going to throw them right on, right at the grill.
Okay.
Bone side down. Then you're going to take your apple
cider. And this
cider,
is after you've baked it then for
right.
a while. All right.
And just ladle it right on.
Ooh, look at that.
Wow. Now you can see the chunks of garlic that are in there.
Mm-hmm.
That's what's in the sauce as well. Oh. So you have your chunks of garlic.
I'm making a
your
mess.
Your pepper,
Sorry.
Your cinnamon. That's ribs are good when
wow.
they are a mess.
Right? Okay. Look at that.
And you're going to do
nice.
That for about 3 minutes and let it sit right there.
Zoom, can you hear the sizzle? Wow.
Now we took the liberty of go ahead and starting some right already.
Okay.
So why don't you just take that ladle, well, the brush.
The brush?
Just brush on the top.
All right. Larry, I like that you put me to work. Now, what restaurant are you at? Which
I'm at Rockside Road in Independence, Longhorn Steakhouse.
So people can come find you there.
And they can come see me tonight. I'll be working.
All right, good. Boy, you do everything.
Yes, I do.
All right, now, you did share all this with us, the apple cider and
yes.
the recipe with us.
Yes.
So you can find that on our website, fox8.com. And go visit these guys. Or you can also make it, but you could
if
order
you
it from
it
you guys.
If experts, come and see us. Especially at Rockside Road.
That might be easy, just a little takeout too.
Just
All
a little
right.
takeout. I tell you what, we also have some done already.
I'm
we're
going in.
Flip it, baste it, and
okay.
we're going to bring these right over here, see how they are.
Look how close. I think I might need to try. Oh my gosh, they fall right
they
off.
They fell right off.
Mm, oh my goodness.
It's delicious, isn't
Amazing.
It? delicious.
Larry, you rock.
Well, awesome. Thank you.
Larry Barnett, check him out, Longhorn Steakhouse. Thanks for sharing your recipe with us.
My pleasure, anytime.
You can really taste the flavor in the apples.
You can taste everything on them. It's like, you taste the garlic as well?
Mm-hmm.
It's
mm-hmm.
delicious. Do you taste the cider?
Mm-hmm. I'm in a happy place.
To prepare our Fox 8 recipes and more, shop at Dean Supply.